Say hello to my little friend. Hello everyone, this is the Doctor and welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Online. Today we are going to talk starships. I've got another one to show you. This video will be an introduction of that ship. We'll talk about it, we'll go over the stats, go over my build, and then at the end we'll do a couple of combat scenarios in Tal Dewa as usual. Then the next video will be all Borg STFs, and then the next one after that all Voth STFs. So say hello to the Voth Bastion Flight Deck Cruiser. So this is a lockbox ship. Also can be found in the exchange, because those are exchangeable in the exchange. Imagine that. And even though it looks like a vacuum cleaner, it actually is a really good ship. Now, when I first got this ship, I did make an intro video about it, and I had my doubts at first. I equipped it, I ran it, I didn't like it. However, that opinion has changed. I like this ship now. I've used it a lot more. I've got a better build on it now. I've figured out what it does, what it's good at and what it's not good at, and I like it a lot. I also have the full set on it, because I have the Palisade Science Vessel as well to combine the consoles to get the full ability that this ship has. Well, I say that, but the one ship I'm missing is the Bulwark. You can actually increase its ability even further if you have a Bulwark. You can take that console, put it on the ship, and combine that as well. I don't have that ship, but I have the Palisade Science, and I have the Voth Bastion Flight Deck, so I can, excuse me, so on this character, I can combine those abilities on this ship. So the point and goal of these videos is to show you the Voth Bastion Flight Deck Cruiser, show you its abilities, show you what kind of ship it is, what it can do. It is not about necessarily the build. I build these ships for fun. I do not build for PvP or DPS. I build for what I like and what works for me. I also build based on themes. I like combining sets together and getting all those set bonuses and all that good stuff. So when we look at the build, which we're going to do, just keep that in mind. It is, as it always goes, anybody can build to their liking, and everyone's got opinions and ideas about what's best. You may disagree with options I've chosen. That's perfectly fine. You may agree, and that's great too. Maybe this will give you an idea about what you could do on your ship. But the goal of the video is to show you these ship. That's what these videos are about. All right, so let's get into it. Here we are in space, and here's the ship. We're looking at it up close here, and I've got the Borg Universal Console visual on. I need to turn that off because I actually don't want that on. There we go. So there it is. That's actually, now we need to turn it. I forgot I have the shield visuals on as well. That is what the ship looks like without shield visuals and everything. Real close up on the textures there, you can see. We'll fly it around here to the other side. There's a good view from the front. That's what it looks like. These things here actually light up. There's a certain power that will enable or can enable, and these will light up a kind of multicolored red and yellow color, which is real interesting. It's only happened a few times, or I just haven't noticed it in the past, but it's an interesting power combined with the aceton generator thing. That's kind of cool. I think these light up the red too. Anyway, it's got like a big engine on the back. And I like the shape of it, to be honest with you. It's a shape that you would imagine would be the shape of a starship in space, right? I mean, it's cool seeing flying saucers and all that, but you think of a ship design, and especially a carrier, because this does have hangars, that kind of ship design is familiar to us. So it actually looks really good flying through space. Anyway, I just wanted to give you a good view of it so you can see what it looks like, so you know what to expect. It's got a lot of design features on it. It looks really nice anyway. I like the design. I like the looks of it. Looks are always a good thing. Okay, so what have I done for my build? Before we jump into my build, let's just go over a little bit about this. I'm reading this from a webpage sitting beside me on my other monitor. Says, after the first hostile contact with Voth starships in the Solanae Dyson Sphere, the Dyson Joint Command quickly came to respect and fear the defensive capabilities of these vessels. Voth starship technology heavily focuses on turning an enemy's own strength into a weakness. Many unwary captains combating the Voth threat have unleashed a withering and desperate barrage of energy weapon fire on Voth starships, only to have it turned against them due to their reflective immunity matrices. The Dyson Joint Command decided that it was impressive to study the Voth's technology by salvaging their starships and repurposing them for their own needs. So this is from the Season 8 dev blog number 21, if you're curious. So here's what it says. The Bastion Flight Deck Cruiser is one of the rank-and-file soldier vessels of the Voth's expeditionary force. They are well-equipped to handle just about any situation that comes their way, and come with one fully operational hangar bay for launching fighters or support craft to aid them in combat. The ship comes equipped with a reactive shield amplifier console that can temporarily render the ship immune to all sources of incoming damage. While the console's ability is activated, incoming energy weapon fire will be redirected back at the ship that's initiating the attack, causing the attackers to damage themselves. The ability is relatively fragile and can be dispersed before its duration has ended. See, the Voth Bastion Flight Deck Cruiser comes standard with one hangar bay of Voth Heavy Fighters. Voth Heavy Fighters are armed with anti-proton arrays, transphasic chronotron torpedoes, emergency power to shields 1, and emergency power to weapons 1. Equipping both the Aceton Field Generator, which is from the Palisade science ship, and the Reactive Shield Amplifier consoles allow the ship to use the Voth Cloak, as well as granting a small passive bonus to damage resistant rating. And here are the stats. Hull Strength 44,000, Shield Modifier 1.2, Crew 1,500, Weapons 4 aft, Device slots 4, hangar bays 1, bridge officer stations 1, lieutenant tactical 1, commander engineering 1, lieutenant commander science 1, ensign universal, and 1 lieutenant universal. Okay, and there's things happening around me out here. Console modifications 3 tactical consoles, 4 engineering consoles, and 3 science. Base turn rate of 6 degrees per second. It's slow. Impulse modifier 0.15, minus 5 all power, or plus 5 all power. Matter antimatter warp core, console universal reactive shield amplifier, cruiser communication array abilities. It's got command shield frequency modulation and command attract fire. Now, when we look at this setup, we have to keep in mind that this is a cruiser based on a slow turn rate and based on engineering. They have 4 engineering console slots and a commander engineering bridge officer station. So you start to think of this ship as a cruiser slash hangar bay ship. It only has one hangar bay, it doesn't have two. So it's not so much a carrier as it is a cruiser. It's more like a cruiser slash carrier, but more leaning toward cruiser than carrier. You know what I'm trying to say? And if you think of it like that and fly it like that, it does quite well. So obviously, with it turning so slow, because it's a cruiser, tanking, you're going to think tanking, engineering, all that, I thought beams. I mean, you know, I don't think it supports cannons anyway. But even if it did, you know, this is a beam boat because it's so slow. I went with. Actually, I want to fly out of range of everybody here because they are so loud. Everybody's messing with the powers, activating them, and everything. That's annoying. Okay, so let's get out here. Alright, let's look at what we've got here. Now, this ship is based on anti-protons in mind. The Voth fire anti-proton weapons. There is a specific Voth anti-proton weapon for your ship and your ground. They're all about anti-protons. So keeping with that theme, and what the Voth use, and trying to keep the whole Voth feel of the ship, because really that's what I'm trying to do here. I want to try to keep that Voth feel. I want to show you everything Voth about it. There are Voth beam arrays. These are Voth anti-proton beam arrays. They also have dual beam banks. They also have ground weapons as well, but it's Voth anti-proton. What makes it Voth is that it, I believe it reduces the enemy, let's see. Voth anti-proton weapons have a chance to reduce your target's damage potential when you land a critical hit. So that's what's unique about the Voth anti-proton weapons. Is it better than the flat-out normal anti-proton weapon? In a sense, no. And the only reason is because if you're building for DPS, you would want to go with advanced fleet anti-proton weapons, if you want to stick with anti-proton. The advanced fleet anti-proton beam array does more DPS than the Voth anti-proton beam array, because this only stops at Mark 12, very rare. There is no fleet version, so basically a fleet version is just going to be a little bit better. But it's not a lot, and it's not enough to sway me to using the normal fleet anti-proton arrays. I went ahead and got these Voth anti-proton Mark 12, very rare arrays, and they're working just fine. I've got accuracy, crit D damage, on this one. I don't even know what modifiers I'm using. I guess they're all accuracy, critical damage, and damage modifiers on them. And that seems to do well. Anti-proton, remember, is all about the critical hits that you do, the critical damage that you're doing, critical severity, as it's called. So I thought the same thing with these. I wanted to beef that up a little, get more critical severity, also add damage on so the DPS is a little bit higher than normal, and then accuracy, because like anything else, accuracy is a big thing. So that's what I went with to keep with the theme. Now, of course, you can put any type of beam on here. Just remember to buff it correctly. That's really the important part. And with these Voth anti-proton beam arrays, which I got from the exchange, very easy to get, I went with the Obelisk Warp Core, the Subspace Rift Warp Core, and the reason why is because there's a two-piece bonus when you combine it and the 360 omnidirectional beam. When you add these two together, you get this thing called Focused Anti-Proton Emitters. So what's that? That is plus 10% anti-proton damage. So it makes sense. If you're building an anti-proton, it doesn't matter if you're using Voth anti-proton or Fleet anti-proton or whatever anti-proton weaponry, the Obelisk Subspace Rift Core plus the omnidirectional proton beam will give you plus 10% more anti-proton damage. So I'm benefiting from that bonus from those two things. Plus, this is a 360 anti-proton beam anyway, which means when I'm forward firing on my Voth Bastion cruiser here, it's going to benefit from that beam firing forward as well, whereas these two beams back here can only fire from the side or back. This one will help fire forward when I'm firing forward with these three other beams, so I'll have four beams going forward. And then also from the side, it'll just give me another beam as well. Also, the same thing is true with the kinetic cutting beam. It's also 360, so that's also going to fire forward. So now I have 3, 4, 5 beams firing forward from one ship. Amazing. And I can do that because, again, this is anti-proton based. It goes with that. It goes with the weapons I'm using. It's all working together. And I have this combined, or the kinetic cutting beam combined with the universal console set, so that I get Omega Weapon Amplifier, which, remember, again, increases weapon power and weapon power resistance and maximum weapon power resistance. So that is beneficial, especially on a beam boat. So all those things are working together, and that's my build. It's Voth anti-proton all the way. Now, there is another Voth weapon. It's a torpedo. I forget which one it is. It starts with a C. I don't think it's Chronoton. I think it's that other one that I can't think of the name of right now. But it is a Voth torpedo, but it's not as good. And I would rather use a really good torpedo. So you know what I got from the Dyson reputation? I firmly stand behind this torpedo. It is my new favorite thing. It is the gravimetric photon torpedo launcher Mark 12. And this is from the, you go to reputation, your Dyson joint command, and you go to space gear, and you scroll down and you will see it down here, gravimetric photon torpedo. I recommend it. It costs 500 Dyson marks. I recommend this torpedo. It's fast and it's powerful. So that's what I went with on this ship. Now it is part of a set. It's part of a Dyson set. You can get the proton particle stabilizer weapon or a console and an experimental proton weapon. You put all those together, you have even more bonuses, arsenal synergy and particle stabilizers. But most of all that relates to proton damage, and I'm doing anti-proton, and believe it or not, that's different. So if you want to buff proton damage, that's a whole different ball game that is not quite set itself in the game yet. You have to use these tactical consoles from the Dyson reputation in combination with protonic Polaron weapons to get the full benefit of all that. So it's a totally different thing. That's better used on the Dyson ship, the Dyson science destroyers. So on this ship, I'm Voth anti-proton, but the gravimetric photon torpedo is sweet. It does work with high yield and spread. And now if I got the console, just the console that goes with this, which is the proton particle stabilizer, it does have a very good two-piece bonus, which I don't have set up right now, but this I could do. And that adds plus 22.9% photon projectile weapon damage. So if I want to do even more damage with this torpedo, which it can do, all I need to do is get like the console that goes with it, and we'll get more photon projectile weapon damage with it. Plus we'll get a little bit more, we'll get plus 3% critical chance with that as well. The only reason why I don't have that console right now is I really don't have the space for it, because I like the consoles I have here now, and I don't really want to remove any of them to put another console in just for more torpedo damage. Because I have the two pieces from, well, the piece from this ship plus the aceton from the Palisade, so that I can get the Voth benefits of that, or the set benefits of that, which is the Voth cloak and the Voth reinforced hull. So I'm benefiting from that. And I also have an RCS accelerator because the ship turns so slow. So let's go through my consoles then. This is the engineering. I like to have the neutronium alloy, the fleet one. This also improves ship hit points or your health points of your ship, which is your hull strength. I also got an RCS accelerator. Alternatively, you could use the tachyonetic converter from the Lobi store, but the fleet RCS does more flight turn rate than that does. So this is actually better than the tachyonetic converter in terms of flight turn rate. So I'm getting plus 42.5% flight turn rate, and also another modifier with that, I'm improving ship hit points again, plus 10.6. So both of these are improving my ship structural integrity. That's just incredible. So I'm building, as you can see, this ship is a cruiser, a tanky cruiser. EPS, assimilated module. Now here are the sets that comes with the ship. This one comes with the Bastion, and it is the reflective shield amplifier. It's a damage immunity plus reflect. Shield will last for 20 seconds. It will decrease your flight speed and turn rate, but it does reflect 100% of incoming damage back at the attacker while it's active. So win-win. Now this one came from the Palisade Science, the Voth Palisade Science Vessel. I'm going to show you that science vessel in another future set of videos, because I have it on my science character, but I also got an extra one on this character so that I could steal the aceton field generator from it and put it on this ship so that I can show you the Voth cloak and the Voth reinforced hull. But this is also an ability as well. The aceton field generator is a scaling energy resistance and radiation explosion. It does AoE energy drain. Toggles on acetone mode for 20 seconds. After it is done doing its thing, draining all that energy from your enemy, it will release an aceton shockwave after 20 seconds. So that's a that's an ability it does. Probably helps more if you have high aux power, which I don't have on this ship. Probably really good for a science character. But if you put it in combination with this console, you see there's a set 2 bonus here. And that set 2 bonus is Voth Cloak. Straight up, I now can cloak. It's not a battle cloak, though, and that's unfortunate. I wish it was a battle cloak. So you cannot cloak while you're in red alert. That is the downside. However, in combination with that set 2 bonus, you also get Voth Reinforced Hull, which is a plus 10 all damage resistance rating. So again, building a tanky cruiser here. Plus 10 all damage resistance rating just by having those two consoles on. Oh, I see. Okay, Voth Battle Cloak. So you do get a Voth Battle Cloak if you have the third thing, which is the Ward Repair Ship console. Now you get that from the Bulwark, which is a really big one. I don't have that ship. It's in the exchange, but it's really expensive, and I do not have the energy credits, nowhere near enough. So I just don't have the resources to get that ship. Yes, I want that ship. Yes, I want to try it, and yes, I would make videos on it if I had it, and yes, I would combine all the consoles and be like, whoa, this is awesome, but I don't have it, so I can't show you that. But if you had that console from that ship, there you go, a set 3 bonus called Voth Battle Cloak. So you do have a battle cloak, you just have to have that third console. So anyway, I don't. Again, thinking of a tanky ship, maximum shield capacity. And then three tactical consoles. I want this to be a powerful ship too. I don't want it to just be tank. I want it to, you know, it's got all these beams and stuff. I want it to do damage. So I filled up the tactical console slots with the fleet vulnerability exploiters that give anti-proton damage and then increase my critical severity on each one. Now I did upgrade the hangar. Okay, it comes with a set of Voth heavy fighters. But in the, what was it? Was it this here? Ship in space items. Ship equipment. Hangers. And no, that's not where I got it. Well, I got it from somewhere. And I can't remember where. Oh, maybe it's special items and boxes. That's where I got it. Yes, so it is there. It's under special. Costs 25,713 dilithium, but it is called the Voth Advanced Heavy Fighter. So it's a little bit better than what comes with the ship, normally. They fire anti-proton arrays again, transphasic chroniton torpedoes. I think that's what the torpedo is. I was trying to come up with above transphasic. Not, it's not a C. It's a T. Transphasic. But it is chroniton too. It's like a transphasic chroniton, so it's a hybrid torpedo. Beam overload 1, power to shields 2, power to weapons 2. So I can launch 2 wings of these, and I think I'll have 4 of these Voth Advanced Heavy Fighters out at all times around me doing things. So that's helpful. But I do, you know, it's not, if it were really built as, let's say, a carrier, it would have 2 hangers. So here's my stats. Look at my hull strengths. Remember, we've got hull being boosted here. I've got hull being boosted from passives in my reputations as well. It's got damage resistance. My hull on this thing is 67,158. Holy cow. I didn't even realize it was that high till just now. I'm getting close to 70,000 hull on this thing. That's amazing. Absolutely amazing, right? My shield strength is at 16,000. Remember, it has a 1.2 shield modifier, plus I got the shield capacitor increase, and I am using the Mako shields, or adapted Mako, which has the highest shield capacity. Look at that, 10,000 shield capacity on that thing. My resists are at a very high 35%. Again, I'm all those resists are building into that. 35%. Can you believe that? It's incredible. This is a tank. Now, I am on my engineering character, and thank goodness, because that's what's going to benefit it the most. 83.1 crit severity. Oh, yeah. My crit chance is real low, but when I do crit, critting some good stuff. Now, as I said, movement's slow, but you learn to deal with that in a ship like this. All right, let's look at the stations. It does have a commander engineering, so you've got to build it with that in mind, right? I went with emergency power to weapons 3. I was able to train myself in that and do that, and I've never used it before until now, but this will increase the DPS on my beams even more than like emergency power 1 or whatever. And an emergency power to weapons 3 build on a beam ship like this is very powerful. Let me tell you, it is very powerful. And then for healing, engineering team 2, and emergency power to shields 1. Now for science, I have a lieutenant commander science here. So I did hazard emitters 3, so I can get all that crap off me and heal my hull as well. Transfer shield strength 2, and polarize hull 1. Now I went with, unfortunately it's a little lack on the tactical stations, but I was able to do beam fire at will 2, and torpedo high yield 2. And then I have torpedo spread 1 and tactical team 1. So I would love to have like FAW 3 or high yield 3. I would love to have something like that, but the space just isn't there for it. It is what it is. Okay. Now, for turning, what I've done to help turn a little bit better is I have emergency power to engines 1. And that will help my turn rate when I'm turning. Oh, let me turn my visuals back on. I like the visuals from the adaptive Mako shields on this. When I enable the visuals, watch this. It gives it a very shiny look. It's shiny and it looks like metal. It really looks like metal. You know, I think it looks really good like that. So I keep those visuals on. Okay, so I want to change instances real quick because it looks like I'm being followed. But I want to, what I want to show you is, let's come out to space. I want to show you the turn rates and everything and how it moves. And now I'm too close to the starbase, so I'm going really slow. There we go. All right, well, we're gonna get out here, and then I'm gonna show you how it turns. We'll look at some maneuverability, and we'll look at enabling some of the powers. Okay, so I'm going impulse. If I want to turn, here's how it turns. This is with the RCS accelerator. So you can see it's slow turning, so you really have to build it with that in mind. So even with the RCS, that's how slow it's turning. I mean, it's going to take me a long time just to come to a full 360. Now, if I combine evasive maneuvers and emergency power to engines, now look how fast I can turn. That's why I like using those abilities combined together. Plus, it helps me move faster and get to my enemy quicker. All about maneuverability. Now, here's the fighter. We'll launch the fighter. See, it launches 2 of them. There they are out there. Now when this cools down, I can launch 2 more and I'll have 2 around me. Or 4 around me, excuse me. While it's doing that and that's cooling down, here's the aceton generator mode, activate aceton mode. So I enable that. Now when I get near an enemy and they attack me, I will start draining their power onto me. And now when this cools down, it will release an aceton explosion. Now I can launch 2 more of those. Now I have 4 Voth fighters, and that's all that I can have out at a time. But
warning, ship is under attack.
That's the aceton explosion. So that's that. Now here's the cloak. It's a Voth cloak, specifically a Voth cloak. It even says Voth cloak. And now I will show you the reflective immunity matrix. You've seen the Voth use this. Well, now I can too. There it is. Very cool looking effect. There's my fighters. It's a good view of them. And it does have the command modes. It's got command shield frequency modulation. So I can enable that and have shield frequency modulation. That has plus 10% damage reduction to shields and plus 10% shield regeneration. Or I have this ability called Attract Fire, which it's a threat increase. It decreases ally threat, scaling damage resistance buff when you have it activated, but it's a threat generation for yourself, basically. I never use it, but it's there. So those are the abilities of the ship. Now let's do what we normally do. Let's warp out and go to Taldewa, do a couple of sector patrols, or a couple of star systems at least, and try to show you some of these features in combat so that you can pinpoint them out. I am using the Mako deflector and the Mako impulse engine, but the adapted Mako shield, and that's for a reason. And I forgot what that reason is, but for some reason the stats lined up better for what I was doing. I specifically want to show you the Graviton torpedo. We'll do the Aceton mode. I'll show you that. I'll show you the cloak, of course, and the reflective immunity matrix. We will do all those things so that you can see the special abilities the ship has. And then also, I will just flat out kill everyone with this thing. It's actually pretty powerful. I didn't want to say no. It's actually a pretty powerful ship.
Jolan Tru, your efforts, security, we have much to do.
Let's start where we started in the last one. We'll just do the same ones each time. It makes it simple and easy. So in this first one, we will focus on enabling the abilities, and I'll show you the abilities. In the second system, I won't even talk. I'll just go in and I'll kill everything as fast as I can. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to launch my fighters. I always start off by doing that. I'll go ahead and engage my
cloak. These guys picked the wrong system.
We have the Enterprise helping us, but that's all right. I'll come here. Enable my shield frequency modulation. Oh, my cloak went away. Oh well. Let's do the Aceton. Let me show you that first. Let me get close to them. As they fire on me, see, there's the Aceton stuff going toward me. I'm doing that. I'm sucking them dry. And then it just released the big burst. Look how easily I destroyed that warbird already. That's the Graviton torpedo. See what it does, that ability? That's pretty sweet. Okay, let me show you the reflective immunity matrix. Now that it's enabled, see, look, it's doing damage back at the enemy. See that it's firing Look at that, I'm not even firing right now. It's doing all that damage back at the enemy. Unfortunately, it doesn't last too long and it's fragile. It's over. But you can see that it was doing damage back at the enemy. Very nice. Let's see, my fighters are out there. Where are they? Hard to find them. They're out there doing something. There they are. They're firing. See, they're working. They're doing their thing. Here's torpedo spread. Well, I killed it, but I'm not even trying, and I'm taking down these enemies. Look, I'm taking, like, hardly any damage. There's the graviton thing again. Let's do a high-yield graviton on the Mogai. There it goes. Heavy oh, it got destroyed. I'll try it again. Nice. Gravimetric. That's the gravimetric distortion. I do want to show you the high yield, though. We'll get one out where they won't destroy it. Closer to a ship. Won't have time to destroy it. There it goes. High yield. Look at that. That's the high yield grav torpedo. Nice. I wasn't even trying in that mission. I mean, really, I wasn't even trying. It kind of depleted my crew a lot, but I'm taking, like, no damage from these people, and totally devastated them. Wasn't even trying. It's a powerful ship. I've really grown to like this. I really have, to be honest with you. Let's go to Japori. Let's do it. On this one, I'm going to keep my mouth shut. And I'm just gonna fight like I normally fight, and we'll see how fast I can get this system done. And note, my crew is not at 100% even yet, so keep that in mind. It would be even a little bit better if they were already at 100%, but they are halfway there. That means my powers will probably not regenerate. My subsystems won't regenerate as fast. Okay, that. Now the Enterprise came here.
These guys picked the wrong system. These guys picked the wrong system.
My cloak didn't stick again.
Target shields have failed.
Yeah. There you go. Not bad, not bad. I like this cruiser slash hangar. Or a cruiser slash flight deck cruiser.
These guys picked the wrong system.
Yeah. So let's go back to the Sol system, and I'll show you the difference that emergency power to weapons 3 makes on the DPS there. I know some people will be curious about that, and I can show you. So right now, I am doing 936.3 depths. I enable emergency power to weapon 3. It's now 1087. So there you go. It helps. And of course, I'm doing more anti-proton damage than I am DPS. Almost 1400 anti-proton damage. Now I know it's not the highest DPS and all that stuff, but it's good for beams. It's not terrible. Plus, that's not the way I build anyway. I build for themes, and I build for fun, and I build what works. And you know what? This works! Anyway, I know this has been a long, talky introduction video, as they always are, but I just wanted to get across how much I like this ship. And it is one of the good ones now. At first, I didn't think so, but I like it now. It's a very, very good ship, and it looks really, really wonderful. I gotta say, I like it a lot. I am impressed by it. So, I'm going to leave it there, and our next video will be taking this ship into battle with the Borg. And then following that, the Voth. So, thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next. Uh-oh, video's not over yet, so there's one thing I forgot to do a day later after making the entire video and rendering the video. I realized I did not show you the bridge of the Voth Bastion Deck Flight Cruiser, so here I am recording extra video, adding it on to the end, because I promised I would do this, and I know it's been a problem in the past, so I'm going to try not to forget from now on. But let's go visit my bridge. See, visit Starship Bridge. This is something that I need to do on all the ships that have unique bridges. Now, not every ship has a unique bridge, but the ones that do, I definitely want to show you and give you a tour of the ship and let you see it from the inside. So here we go, if the load times will load. Sometimes this can take a while. And apparently I'm getting 5,000 PMs and I just logged on. Any second now. Wow, that's a long load time. Come on, you can do it. There, hey, that worked. All you gotta do is be nice to it. So, you've probably seen this bridge before. I did show it in a couple of videos in the past, doing some updates from this bridge, but this is it. This is the Voth Bridge, and it's the same on the Bastion flight deck as it is on the Science Palisade. It's gigantinormous. Gigantinormous, yes, I just made that word, and I'm gonna stick with it, gigantinormous. So what we have here is this screen that any sports fan would die for, okay? Then, or any movie enthusiast also, it's like a theater-sized screen as their view screen. So I love that. And what you'll notice about the bridge is that it's not on the outside of the ship, it's on the inside. So as you can see through this window here, I'm inside the ship. The bridge is inside the ship. Now that has its advantages and disadvantages. One advantage, it's hard for an enemy to target the bridge and destroy the bridge because it's inside your ship. disadvantage, you don't have any real windows to the outside. You rely on the view screen. So let's say the view screen goes out, you've got no reference to what's going on outside. I like to have real windows to the outside world. Give me a view of space around me that I can look out a natural window and see what's going on in combination with the view screen. Of course, even in, for example, the Enterprise D or Enterprise E or Voyager, those ships never had windows either. They totally rely on your view screen to see space. Now, they did have an upper part kind of ceiling where you could see space through like little slits in the ceiling, but otherwise they were kind of the same as well. But this ship, this bridge, totally on the inside. So what do we have here? This is select a small craft. We can get in our shuttle. We can access our account bank from here. So that's nifty to easily get to your account bank wherever you are, no matter where you are. You can contact duty officers and do diplomatic envoys, tactical department, science, medical, main engineering, operations, counselor, chef, bartender. Tons of DOF missions you can do here. See if we can go through this door. That is a negatory. On this side, we have the library files to access. Some of my bridge officer crew, and we can't go through that door. So there's the bridge. Let's go this way. I don't think I've ever been through this door, to be honest with you. Actually, we can't go through that door. Never mind. So what was this? That was library files. So I guess that's it then. I was hoping it would have like a ready room. We can either leave or bridge invitations, but I was hoping it would have like a ready room we could go visit. But apparently no. There's no option to do that. Yeah, none of these doors actually work, so we can't go anywhere else on our ship. That's unfortunate. I would have liked to have visited other places of the Voth ship. Yep, none of these doors work, so we're just locked into the bridge. And that's it, that's all there is. It's kind of a shame. Oh well, can't do anything else. So we will sit in our captain's chair, which is very far away from all the console stations, and we'll just be the captain. So there you go, there's a look at the bridge. I hope you all enjoyed that. So now we will do the Borg videos coming up next. So thank you, and stay tuned for the next.